As we reported earlier, Cagayan bearing the brunt of Typhoon Egay. We now have with us Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba. Governor Mamba, good afternoon to you. Thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Thank you to Carmina, and good afternoon to all your listeners and viewers.
Governor, how would you describe the situation in Cagayan as we speak?
Well, we are on typhoon signal number 4 in the northern part of the province. That's about 13 towns, and the other towns in the province is under signal number 3. And we don't have work now since yesterday, and that we are now being pummeled by the typhoon, especially in the north. No, and we do not have casualties, reported casualties at this point in time. Our lifelines, especially electricity, we don't have electricity in northern part of Cagayan, but we have intermittent interruption of our electric power here in the southern part of Cagayan. We are under gale warning, so there are no ocean and seas around us. And, We also have canceled flights for air. So anyway, we are now also trying to assess, because we are monitoring Cagayan River and its tributaries, because it's also swelling. This early morning at 5 a.m. it's already 6.2 meters high in Buntun. The alert level is about 9 meters, and the critical level is 12 meters. And so we're also, after the typhoons, we expect the swelling of our rivers because of the rainwater coming from Cordillera, Sierra Madre, and of course, Caraballo, exiting in Cagayan. So at this point in time, we have 12,156 individuals in the evacuation centers, no? But about 2,700 of this is in the Adapt a Neighbor program of the province, and the others are distributed in 137 evacuation centers. These evacuation centers are the schools, the churches, multi-purpose buildings, and even barangay halls.
Governor, how many evacuation centers do you have?
We have evacuees inside evacuation centers, 9,209 individuals, and 2,711 individuals in Adapt a Neighbor.
Right, but how many in total of evacuation centers do you have?
We have 137 evacuation centers in 187 affected barangays.
Governor, you know, Cagayan, when you talk about Cagayan, it's no stranger to typhoons, no stranger to storms, but what makes this one unique?
Well, this is unique in a way that for the 2 super typhoons that we have, this is the first super typhoon hitting the northernmost part of Cagayan. The 2 other super typhoons in 2016 and 2018 hit the southern part of Cagayan. So this is their first experience also. And this sort of super typhoon is quite different because it only became a super typhoon category when it's already near the coastlines of Cagayan. And so it could take us by surprise, but we really appreciate the OST and Pag-asa telling us that this could have a rapid intensification. And that's what it did, no? It hit us at 185 kilometers per hour with gustiness of 230 or 220. And then diminished into a typhoon category at 175 kilometers per hour with a gustiness of 240 kilometers per hour. when it hit Fuga Island.
Mm-hmm. And because of this, and because of climate change, Governor, we don't know if this is going to be the norm or if this is going to be a one-off. But even so, any interventions that you're thinking of right now to further mitigate any future effects of future storms and typhoons which will hit the area that it's hitting right now?
Well, we did a lot of adjustments already, no? From informing our people of these times that it is becoming a new normal for all of us here. We also did the Build Back Better, of including that of our infrastructure. In fact, after this disaster, we will be calling a workshop seminar again on what we've learned from this. And we saw to it that we have science-based decision-making, no? By really getting the OST and all other agencies to advise us on what to do. No, and of course, our infrastructure, including that of our tree planting time, no, or planting time of our crops, no, we're trying to adjust all of these to so that we could avoid these kinds of typhoons hitting us with our starving crops, no, being damaged that badly. So all of these things, no, we learned from it. We're trying to learn from others too. But I think we became, in a way, experts about super typhoons now, because this is the third super typhoon that hit Cagayan in the last 7 years, since the time I was incumbent governor. And we really tried to learn from it so that we could also download this to our people at the same time. Other people could also learn from us.
Governor, a resident meteorologist telling us just a while ago that things will look better, maybe or gradually begin to look better by tomorrow. But even then, even as early as now, do you already have an estimated cost of damage to, let's say, infrastructure, agriculture, even private property, Governor?
We're doing that now, no, but I believe not that this will not end the typhoon, because our rivers are now swelling, no, and water is just coming down the range, the mountain ranges, and that is why we're again expecting flooding in along Cagayan River and its tributaries. That is why I am forewarning people too that this will not end with that super typhoon leaving us, but we still have to address the swelling of the Cagayan River and that of the Abulug River, because these are the ones also causing most of our damages, especially our crops.
Governor, just as a final question, and we do want to let you know about this situation, because we just had our correspondent Rafael Busano, who's currently situated in Sitio Port Irene. A couple of minutes ago, he did a live report for us, and he did say that already barely 12 hours since the onslaught of a super typhoon Egay in that area, residents are already there trying to pick up the pieces, trying to fix their homes. Is it safe for them, Governor? And if it's not, what are you going to do about it?
Well, the flooding, we expect it along the Cagayan River. No? The storm surge, which was what we preempted, no? That's why we came up for preemptive evacuation, because of the storm surges that could come, no? As high as, according to the OST, more than 3 meters. No? And if the wind has gone down, I think initially maybe they could start, but really it is not really advisable even at this point in time, because we feel that tomorrow would be a better time.
Yeah. All right. Please do keep us updated on anything that's happening there because of Super Typhoon Egay. But in the meantime, we're going to have to thank you and leave you for now. We do wish you well in your recovery efforts, Governor Mamba.
Thank you, Carmina, and God bless. And thank you for giving us this time.